morning, everyone.
Amen.
What a nice opportunity for each one of us to sit at the feet of Jesus. Amen?
Amen.
And singing praises to his name and his name alone, who is the creator, redeemer, sustainer of our lives. The very breath of life that we are breathing today is because of his mercy. And he gave us another Sabbath where we could be able to worship him in spirit and in truth. With this, I want to take this opportunity to welcome each and every one of you in the matchless name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. We're very happy that you're here with us worshiping. And I hope this experience will help each one of us to draw closer with Jesus. Once again, I take this opportunity to welcome each and every one of you in the matchless name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ.
Amen.
We are having some visitors worshiping with us today. We want you to feel at home. This is a small family homely church. And you're most welcome. I'm very happy that you could be here with us. Anyone, any new members who are coming for this church for the first time? First time, anyone who's coming for our church for the first time. Can we ever see your hands or just please do raise up? We request you. We have a small token of appreciation. I think so, the brother is here, okay? I think so, this is the first time I'm seeing you, okay? Yeah, can we introduce yourself, sir, first? I'll be happy. Yes, yes. Brother Andrew Matthew, very happy that you could be a part of us, okay? Okay, yes. We'll please do stand up and we will have a small token of appreciation for you. And of course, but my friend here, who are those lovely two people who are there with us today, will you be introduced to us?
Oh yeah, these are my parents, my mom and my dad.
Wow! Very happy you have a lovely son. Let me be very honest with you, we have a very lovely son, very lively son. And we want to welcome you wholeheartedly to the HopeSide Community Church. We want to welcome Brother Chintas and his lovely wife too with us, okay, worshiping with us today. And any other issues that we have? Irrespective of where we are, new or old, we are at the feet of Jesus, we all are one, and it gives an immense pleasure to welcome each one of you. Thank you for joining with us today. And it's time to meet and greet one another, so let's all rise up and welcome each one of us with a Christly warmth to the sanctuary to worship the Lord in spirit and in truth.
Amen.
Much more than I do, I want to praise you. Much more than I do.
Thank you.
I do have a few announcements to be made. I want you to please pay close attention to us. This is the fourth week of the month. We always is focused on outreach matters. Here's a hope to reflect on this theme. Evangelism without social work is deficient. Social work without evangelism is important. Not important. Get this once again. Evangelism without social work is deficient. Social work without evangelism is important. That's what we say. There is always a free training courses are offered to learning music and computers on Thursday evening starting at 6 p.m. And please do visit the website at hopeside.org/training. You'll be able to get the latest information in that one. A lot of things are happening in this church by His mercy and His grace. August 3, that is the next week, 2019, a special Sabbath to mark the expansion of our church with new members. Please do invite others too. If you wish to join HopeSide as a member along with this new group, please let us know. And you can be able to make sure the file link to see and share. That is hopeside.org/program. And you will be able to find a link there, and you can be able to go there too. So August 3 will be a very, very important expansion of our church. We want you to please do join in with us and encourage us in this one. And may the Spirit of the Lord enable each one of us with the spirit of evangelism, drawing many more souls to this kingdom. At the same, next week, August 3 at 6 p.m., Dr. John Bilmoria, a Telugu gospel artist, will be in the concert at HopeSide Church in the sanctuary. All are invited. We can pass on this message through, and you can be able to find this link to in hopeside.org. August 17, 6 p.m., Sharon George, a singer of the popular Hindi gospel song called Dhanyavaad Ke Saath. If you have been able to listen to some of the Hindi songs, this is one of the most popular songs that we had, and Sharon John, even though she's a Malayali, and she will be able to sing a very good Hindi songs too. So, will be a concert here at HopeSide. She will also perform at Southern Asian Church too during the divine service on the same day, and dinner will be followed. All are welcome, and there's a link too, and you can be able to follow that part on HopeSide.org. And of course, Psalms. A free from interdenominational praise and worship event is every quarter on the second Saturday of the month at 6 p.m. in the sanctuary, followed by the potluck dinner in the fellowship hall. So the next Psalms, that is the free form of interdenominational praise and worship event, will be held on September 14th. Please do mark the date, and you could be a part of it or invited. And of course, after the church service, all are invited to a fellowship lunch that follows after the divine service in the fellowship hall located in the next building. We don't want anyone to just leave, just go that way. We want you to fellowship with us physically too. And so we want to invite you for the fellowship dinner after the divine service. So these are the few announcements that I had. And of course, every Saturday at 8:30, we do have special healing prayer ministry happening in the sanctuary. Anyone who is difficulty, financial difficulties, whatever the healing difficulties there might be, let us bring it to the Lord. And that's the time the Lord answers our prayers in every moment. So please make sure that pass on this word, and you can be a part. Every Saturday from 8:30 to 9:15, special prayer meeting session in the sanctuary will be held. But the Lord is in His holy temple, let all the earth keep silent. We are here to worship Him in spirit and in truth. God is good all the time. All the time.
God is good.
Let's all join in with the heart, mind, and soul to worship in spirit and in truth. Once again, I take this opportunity to welcome each one of you in the matchless name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. The opening song, let's all join in saying, what a friend we have in Jesus. What a friend we have in Jesus. Let's all stand up and sing this beautiful song in order to glorify His name. What a friend we have in Jesus. All our sins and grievances to Him. What a privilege to carry everything to God. Amen. We'll be our next to seek the Lord in prayer. Prayer is a gift from heaven, and you and I got an opportunity to get into the throne room of God. When the Lord is His holy sanctuary, wanting to bless each one of us, He's always ever willing to listen to a sincere heart when we put our supplication to Him. You believe in the name of Jesus, the Lord is going to answer our prayer today. Amen. Even though you are not worthy, but He is worthy. He is worthy of all our praises and is ever willing to discharge that our prayers will be answered because He loves us dearly. It is time to seek the Lord in prayer. anyone in the congregation has any praise report or prayer request, we want you to please do let us know so that we can be able to praise God and pray for any request.
Yes.
Yes,
prayer for our
family. Okay. So we will remember Jima. As it's not been done for a while, and I believe that the Lord will be able to certainly answer a prayer by him. Yes, sister.
Thank God for his protection and care.
Who is an ICU. Yes, sister.
I'd like to praise God and thank him for making me a grandmother.
Oh, praise be to Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah.
My daughter has given birth to a healthy baby boy.
Oh, amen. Amen.
I'd like to thank him for it.
Praise the Lord, sister. We want to thank him. That the children are the heritage of the Lord, and you being grandma is also carrying on the heritage. Okay, the way of the Lord wants. So may God bless you. May God bless you too and your lovely family. Any other praise report or prayer request that we have? And of course, we are we will remember Sister Sharmina Moses, right? Who has a little excruciating pain, that's what I heard about, but may the Lord have mercy on that lovely man so that may the Lord will be able to heal that every other. Any other praise report or prayer requests?
Unspoken
request for Sister Amuda. Let's reverently kneel down and seek the Lord in prayer. Our most gracious, precious, loving, and living Heavenly Father, we thank you, we praise you, we honor you, we glorify your name because you are our God and you made us your children. We are unworthy to call you our Father. But thank you for Jesus Christ, your loving Son, who died on the cross of Calvary, who made a provision. Even though by yet we are sinners, he died for each of our lives, giving us an opportunity to enter into the throne room of God, which is holy. I want to thank you, Lord, for the provision of prayer that we will be able to seek you and be guided by your Spirit. Once again, we commit ourselves to you, O Father. Each one of us bow down before your throne of grace, we commit ourselves, O Father. Forgive us sins and shortcomings that we have committed any. Forgive, O Father, for anything that we have done wrong against your will. O Lord, we are sinful nature human beings, but cover us by the blood of Christ. So, O Father, our sins might not hinder our prayers this morning. We need your love, we need your hug, we need that assurance, we need that hope of Jesus Christ and the promises of your word so that we could believe in the name of Jesus, knowing that our prayers are answered. Lord of heaven, we come in each one of us to your care, keeping any sense, hidden sense, which is there. Please do forgive us. Cover us with your blood and answer this little prayer, Father. I want to thank you for the HopeSide Church and thank you for using us, Father. Even though you're unworthy, you used us mightily. A lot of changes and things are happening in this church by your mercy and by your love. May we be guided by the Spirit with the wisdom and knowledge that we can be able to lead this church the way all the Lord really wants us to. And we honor you in your name. As Lord, we do have have a praise report and a prayer request we want to put forth with you. Let the blessed hand of Christ help us, O Father, so that we might know that the Lord has answered our prayer. I want to thank you, Father, of man who could be able to be a grandmother's children at the heritage of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Thank you for the bundle of joy. May the whole family enjoy every moment of this life, O Father, for the gift from heaven above. May the baby be blessed and certainly be a shining light in the future days. Give good health and strength, physically, spiritually, mentally. Be with the grandparents, strengthen them. As the responsibility increases, O Father, may they guide this child in the way how it is supposed to, and may honor be to your name through their lives too. Yes, Lord, I want to pray for the children in a special way. It's not well. May the right prayers man of Christ be able to touch, then healing physically, O Father, so that he might be able to recognize the mighty hands of Jesus Christ working in his heart, and he could worship you the next week in our sanctuary. Be with the lovely parents, use them mightily with their times. I want to pray for Brother Dennis, who is there in the ICU. I want to put the difficulty that you might be facing, O Father. Lord of heaven, may the name of your Son of Christ be able to be healed physically, spiritually, mentally. I want to pray for the name of his brother who's writing the exams. I hope everything will go on and give them just the knowledge for a while. Especially, I want to pray for Sister Shamila Moses, O Father. She has excruciating pain, that's what we heard. Only the Lord can be able to remove the pain. Lord of heaven, I pray thee in the name of Jesus now that the name pierced hand will be able to touch her, bring healing, so that her pain might be absolutely taken away. And certainly, Father, she will feel the sense of serenity and peace now. So she will have an opportunity to experience your peace and happiness in her life, oh Father. Thank you for hearing our prayers. Pray with Sister Amada with a silent request. You know her heart. You know her everything before her. And believe in the name of Jesus, the Lord of heaven, you fulfill her heart desires. And you will help her point out in her. Be with every individual who brought on before the throne of grace today. What are the difficulties, the maladies, the heartaches, the pain, and the tears that we might be undergoing? But I believe everything will be right. We are here to listen to your word. The word is the lamp unto my feet and the light unto my path. Thank you for choosing Pastor Bovas to be with us. Lord, align him with your double portion of his spirit, that the words of his mouth and the meditation of his heart be acceptable in thy sight. As the flowers opens itself to the sun, help us to open ourselves to the sun of righteousness. So that, O Father, your word might be able to sink into our heart, mind, and soul. And certainly, O Father, we might be able to walk in your ways, the ways that we intend us to walk, and live with you and your Lord. Thank you for everything. Thank you for answering our prayer. Thank you for your presence. Thank you for everything. I ask these few mercies in the matchless name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ.
It is time for the tithe and offerings. There is nothing that we can offer, the Lord says. He wants you and me to be a living sacrifice because we have been created in the image of God. Christ has sacrificed, the whole heaven has sacrificed Christ for you and me. What is there that we should be able to sacrifice to him? There is nothing. We have to render heart, mind, and soul and give ourselves to him. But what were the blessings that he has been bestowed upon? Is our responsibility to return to him with tithe and offering. And any of you being able to give through the check, make sure that you'll be able to give in the name of HopeSide Church. So that you will be receiving And if you want some tax exemption, this is that you will be able to get to it. But much more than that, it is when we give to the Lord, we give it with all whole heart, mind, and soul. And I request to come forward so that we have a small word of prayer before we will collect the offering. Let's seek the Lord in prayer. Gracious God in heaven, we thank you, Jesus. Everything what we have is yours. Nothing is ours, so Father. But whatever that you have been blessed us, help us to return it, to bring honor to your name, O Father, so that we might be able to use it to spread the gospel. And through this, Father, many more souls might come to the foot of Jesus Christ, know your love, to know your truth, and hasten your coming. Thank you for being with us. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Very happy to have Sister Winston and Brother Winston and Charles with us, and they want to render us a special song. Very happy that you're here with us, and God bless you and use you, your talents, to glorify His name.
Happy Sabbath, everyone. Thank you.
What a beautiful voice. What a talent. Praise be to Jesus. May God bless you and use you. I was very much touched by this beautiful song. We all enjoy. Pastor Bovas, Thamson accepted the Adventist message in 1971 when he was studying pre-degree course. After the high school, before he entered to college. He went to Spicer Memorial College in Pune in the year 1973. In the year 1977, graduated as a Bible instructor. In 1977, started working as a literature evangelist. After 3 months of training, he was appointed as a pastor for 3 churches. In the year 1986, Pastor Bovas graduated with Bachelor in Liberal Arts. In 1991, transferred to Veperi School in Chennai, India, as a Bible teacher. In 1993, Pastor Bovas was transferred to Goa as a region director. In 1995, ordained to the Ministry of God. In 1996, appointed to South Kerala section to take care of 3 departments as a department director. In 2003, Pastor Bovas came to US. In the year 2013, he started the Adventist New Vision Fellowship Church with a handful of people. Since then, he's shepherding this church, and I'm one of his flock. Now, Pastor Bovas is not retiring, but he is going back to teach in a theological seminary in Kerala, India. He has a hobby of gardening. We, the member of Adventist New Vision Fellowship Church, benefited. All the vegetables and fruits he gets from his garden, he gave it away. I love gardening myself. But the yield I get from my backyard is very less. Even if I put 10 years of yielding, it will not match 1 year of his. He gets so much from his garden. And I'm still learning from him. From 2013 until now, he's volunteering at church week after week, month after month. He comes to church on time, and he is the first one to show up. In the year 2017, a token of appreciation, we decided to appreciate him with a little money from the church offering. He refused to accept, then finally accepted. Pastor Bovas is blessed with a wife and 5 grandchildren. We wish him well in his future endeavor. God bless you, Pastor Bovas. For scripture meditation, let's turn the Bibles to Jonah, chapter 1, verse 2. Jonah, chapter 1, verse 2. It says, "Arise, go to Nineveh, the great city, and cry against, for their wickedness is come up before me." Once again, I repeat. Arise, go to Nineveh, the great city, and cry against, for their wickedness is come up before me. May God go. And his blessings on the portion of the scriptures just been read. The theme song that we have for us today is "Open Our Eyes, Lord. We want to see Jesus." Many times our internal eyes are closed and unable to perceive what the Lord has in store for each one of us. And we have to request the Lord to open our internal eyes so that we can be able to see Jesus. This will be the theme song. "Open Our Eyes, Lord. We want to see Jesus." Let's all stand up and sing this song.
Joined the church, that was a big history behind it. I was attending a big church Sunday group. My father was the biggest man and he was the main man there on the church. And at the time when I was attending effort meeting, evangelistic meeting, around 3 months by Pastor P.C. Thomas. At the end of the day, that there were 5-7 people who wanted to take baptism, and I did not give my word. And the night that, the night before I was supposed to go for baptism, something was encouraging me, something was forcing me to go and take baptism. So, without the notice of my parents, I just took a bath and rushed to the place where the baptism was arranged. So I got to the bus. The bus was rushed like hell. There was no space to stand and there was no place to sit. So the conductor was asking us to push back, push back, push back. And I just pushed back one after another. And the conductor was keep on asking me, go back, go back. So I was turned and tried to go back. My father was standing right behind me. And I thought that was my last day. Because he was very strong in Sunday worship and he was very much agitated when I was attending the meeting. But he didn't know that I am just going for taking baptism. After baptism, I came with 2 wet clothes and I just put for drying. My father was asking, what is that? I said, I took baptism and I wanted to be a member of Seventh-day Adventist. The first word came out of my father, get out. It was a very, discouraging word that I got from my father. But he was not angry on me. I just waited to leave him and went to see the man who baptized me, Pastor P.C. Thomas. Immediately, he referred me to Dr. Spicer. And in between, by God's grace, till 1991, I finished my master's in theology. Till then, I was very much inspired the message. But after finishing master's, I thought that I would be taken back to the field where I was supposed to take care of the church. But they asked me to go and teach Bible in my Madras school. That discouraged me so much. But that was God's plan to do something else. From there, one after another step, it came and I was promoted many other and came back to a great plan. Now, 2003, I came here and I was just working here and there. And after 2013, I was attending the church, but not regularly. 2013, we some people joined together and discussed to have a fellowship. But before that, I wanted to tell something about a person who encouraged me in the field where I was working in Kerala, Pastor Thomas McCarthy. He is here. A very dedicated man, a man of power, a man of encouragement. Always, he loves me so much as to his own family member. And he encourages me always. Whenever he meets me, he talks and we sit and talk. When I came here, he was the only one who encouraged me first. And after that, there was some issue came around the church and we just started another church that is called Adventist New Mission Fellowship Church. 7 years we were there on the church. And we thought that the church needed to be in a better position. So we contacted many other church leaders, but we could not have very good response. We did not get much response. I got good response from Elder Allen, and we church, everybody sat together and discussed to cooperate with the fellowship of HopeSide Community Church. But in order to continue the church 7 years, two families are very much noted. One, Mr. Kunyachan Harris, his wife, and his younger brother, Mr. Tantal Harris. And both encouraged us very much. When we started, around 7 people were there. And at the time when we started with 7 people, we joined together and started, but none of them, except Mr. Kunyachan, everybody left. And after 2 years, again we just, I think after 1 year, again we were just trying to make sure the church should be continued. By the time I got the 2 friends, one Mr. Prem David, the other one Mr. Jagastin. Oh my God, they integrate the church, they develop the church from 2 to 20. That is something great. Now we have around 20 members. That 20 members are, we are just planning to join with the HopeSide community, and we are just planning to continue the church. We had so much of intention before we start the church as a special group. And we organized many things, we did many things as much as we can, we could. We built around, I think we renovated around 4 churches in Kerala, 2 schools, and many social programs we did, and medical health and so many things we could, whatever we could, we did it. Still we are continuing. And we had a agreement with Mr. Anand that once a month we will have a fellowship together, and all other weeks we will have our separate worship. So we got, they gave me, gave us another place, and we are going to have the worship. Today we are so happy to be with you. And I am planning to leave to my hometown because they need my presence to train ministers. Most of the master graduates in theologies are left from there, and we, some people are there, and they asked me to come back to train some ministers, so I'm going back. This is a small history that I could tell about my service that I did here and at home. And today, just I was thinking that why I should preach here, that I was talking to Mr. Anand. I said, sir, this is the last Sabbath I meant to give the message, and after that I may not be able to give the message. So he said, that is your day. So he asked me to attend and make the bread of life. So today I just want to take a few minutes to study the strategy based on the one message of Prophet Jonah. Focused on messianic prophecy. Little bit about whatever Jonah did in his work time or in his time, whether it is based on the messianic prophecy or his lifestyle. Now this messianic prophecy, I mean his message, it has a base to touch the messianic prophecy. According to the verse of scripture, we have, if you open the Bible, we have 4 major prophets and 12 minor prophets. And Jonah is follow the minor prophets. Why the Bible different to major and minor? That has meaning in it. The major prophets are described as major because their message of conscience are drawn with a global implication. The minor prophets are described as minor because their books are shorter and the conscience are narrowly focused. But both the messenger, both the books, minor and major prophets, their message are congruent with each other. And it says that both major and minor prophets are mainly focused on the restoration of Israel. Most of the messages are sent in with a warning and end with the promises. If you read both the major and minor prophets' message, there will be warning, but you can always find end with promises. Therefore, the beauty of these books, I highly knowledgeable, including parts of holiness, wrath, grace, and mercy. That is the beauty of the book of prophecies. Now, when we go to the book of Jonah, we don't find any evidence of the writer. Jonah is the author of this book. We don't find any authenticity in the book. But we can find that his name is after this book. Because his character, his ways, his talk, his life, everything connected to this book. Therefore, the book is named after the character. He was born in Gate Heper, that's a place near Nazareth. There is a meaning referred to this name Jonah. The meaning is though. The character and the life of though is nothing to compromise with Jonah's lifestyle. Here, we know that though is very polite and anyone can deceive that bird and also it is senseless. That is what it says. But whereas, to match with the name of Jonah, though the meaning of the word cannot be compromised. Therefore, he was nicknamed as chicken. You know what? Why he was nicknamed as chicken? Chickens, when the trouble comes, it's run away. It's just they run away for their life. The same thing that we can find in Jonah's life. Jonah, when he gets any kind of difficulties, he runs away from the place. Therefore, he is nicknamed as chicken. To study the Word of God, shall we open the Bible? The introductory chapter of Jonah and the introductory statement of Jonah says like this, Jonah chapter 1 verse 2, it says that, arise and go to Nineveh, preach against the great city of Nineveh, and cry out against for the wickedness, and the wickedness already is at hand to come and judge them. And there is a warning message that is given to Jonah to go and tell the people, your land is filled with wickedness, so there is something is going to happen, so you must preach them to get out of the wickedness. And the historians, they say, the land of Nineveh was filled with iniquity and wickedness. The wickedness is the personification of guilty or evil. The people of Nineveh cried before the universal judge, that the Lord, God himself, they cried and requested to intervene the problem that is going on in Nineveh. Therefore, God appointed a person called Jonah to go and preach the people the wickedness, what is growing there must stop, and turn back to the Lord who is there with them. But the people were not happy to accept. And people wanted to live according to their own life. So what happened? Jonah was given another message, given in such a way that there is a message. That message is a messenger who is going to come. That messenger is going to be the Messiah. And the Messiah who is going to take care of the land. Therefore, if the warning message is given to you first, the message was like this. Luke chapter 11, verse 30, it says that, for as much as Jonah became the sign of Nineveh, so also the Son of Man will be to its generation. Now, here it's only it says that Nineveh is going to be destroyed. Therefore, and we don't want to destroy. God says, no, we don't want to destroy the people of Nineveh, but I'm going to send you, I'm going to keep me as a sign to give a message. From there, the message you must tell them to understand that God is always with you, and there is a Messiah. The Messiah will come and refuse you down. But the people did not listen much. Why why Jonah was considered as a sign to Nineveh? Sign always represents turning point to right side. When there is a sign, if the drivers, that when you drive, you will find a sign. The sign shows where you're supposed to go. So always, the sign represents where to go to the right place. Therefore, Jonah was appointed as the right person to the right place to turn the people's minds from wickedness to God's holiness. But Jonah had another problem. Jonah was not listening to the word of God. Jonah was always depending upon the men or human around the land. And he was afraid of the king Ahab. And Ahab was looking for the man who is always turning the people from wickedness to God's presence. And Ahab always is a worshiper of idol. And Ahab was looking for Jonah to punish. And Jonah came to know that. What Jonah did? He said, no, I cannot go there. If I go there, King Ahab will kill me. So I must find my own way. What he did? He came to Joppa and found a ship, took the ticket, went to another place called Tarsus. And as soon as he took the ticket, he straight away went to the bottom of the ship and slept nicely. But God wanted to wake him up of the sleep. God sent a wind to the sea to shake the ship, to make him out of the sleep. And the ship captain was very much afraid the ship is going to wreck. So what he did was he was running up and down for the people who are inside. He wanted to save their life. And he prayed the Lord, Lord, what is happening here? What am I doing? The ship is going to wreck and I'm going to
And he put the Lord.
When he put the Lord went on Jonah. And he was asking, where is Jonah? Where is Jonah? No, Jonah was not found there. And he went down. And the Jonah was sleeping very calm and quiet. He was snoring and sleeping. He just woke him up and said, Jonah, you are the trouble for this cause and for these people. And Pilate, what he did was, he asked the Lord, Lord, because of this man, I should be punished. And the Lord told him, put him away from the cloth. Put him away. And he took it and put him in the deep sea. Now, do you think God is the God of anger? No! God is the God of love. Though he was putting the water in the deep sea, God was trying to save his life there. He already prepared something to save his life. Why did God prepare a big fish to save his life? There are seven reasons behind it. One, God prepared a big fish to save his life. That was his priority of his life. And God found a resting place. God wanted to have a resting place for Jonah, even the deep sea, where he is going to be gone. God allowed a big fish to protect him without harm and danger. That was God's plan. And God wanted to see this man to be alive inside the water the days that was prepared for him. And God made him 3 days and 3 nights. He was inside the fish belly and he was protected. And also God has some other plan on him. God wants him to dedicate himself while he was inside the sea. So God has found a place, only the big fish. He went up, when he went inside the fish, he prayed the Lord. Lord, I'm away from your presence. Save my life. Save my life. And he said, Lord, I disobey. Save my life. And his life went down when he disobeyed God. Finally, he was inside the big fish. What is a big fish belly? And he repented. He repented. God lifted him up from the shallow of danger to a plain land of comfort. Brothers and sisters, we may not think what God had planned on Jonah. Jonah was running away from God. God had a plan to keep his life comfort till the message gets over. He wanted to use Jonah to keep the land happy and joyful. Now, he is in the land. God called him again. First thing, he disobeyed. Now, the second thing, when it came, he obeyed God's word. He spoke to him, arise, go to Nineveh and preach about it. Preach against the wickedness. The second day when the message came to me, he accepted. He did not say, no, I will not go. He accepted. And he went to the city. He took one night to get into the city place. And he preached. But his tone was changed from the beginning. God said, go and tell them. Go and tell them. Keep away your behavior, your character, your disobedience, your wickedness. But what he spoke to us, that is something different. He said, after 40 days, God is going to overthrow this land. So this land is not going to be no more, and you are going to die after 40 days. So there will be 40 days for you to live. All of you will be dying. That was not God's plan. No way, that was not God's plan. We do something, God says something, we do another thing. It was says, he told Jonah, go and preach the wickedness what they do. Tell them to convince. Tell them to be baptized. Or tell them to change their mind. Now here, when he spoke, after 40 days, God is going to overthrow this land. And Jonah is waiting till the end of the 40 days. He thought that, okay, the land will be no more, and I will be escaped. But God's plan was a little different on people. He did not know what was going on there. So what he did? When he preached the message, the people of Nineveh, the people who were filled with wickedness and guiltiness, they turned their life. And what they did, they announced a fasting and prayer, not only for human, but also for the animals too. Not only for the human, but also for the animals. The king Nimrod also attended, and he also accepted. What he did, what they did, they put on the sackcloth, and from the greatest to the small, they put on the cloth and prayed. Animals are not exploded. They also joined together. They literally worried about the day of the Lord, the day after 40. They were worried about their life. Here, the prophecy started. We know that the message is given. A Messiah will be coming to take them out of the trouble. And the Messiah is, the Messiah prophecy is literally going to happen now. You know that Belly is a place for, was a place for Jonah's rescue. Now here what happened? While he was put into the sea, through the sea, there was one same place God kept for him, that big fish, Belly. And he stayed there 3 days and three nights. In the prophecy, three has a literal, literal meaning there. There are some little meaning for the number used for three. Mark 17, chapter 12, it says that Elijah has already come. They were thinking that, okay, now Elijah was here, Elijah spoke to Israel, and the people were convinced, and Elijah may have to come. So they were expecting Elijah to come and preach, but the word of the Lord went to them. Elijah already came. Just before Nineveh, just before Jonah came to the power or given the message, Elijah was taken away to heaven. So the message went to them that Elijah cannot come and rescue you out. Elijah cannot come and take you out and give the message. Elijah already gone. Now the present, the man who is appointed there, he is going to give, but Elijah already came. He is not going to come no more. Therefore, God is given a person to you to listen the message. 2 Kings chapter 2, verse 11, it says that when the time was over, He was taken away the life of Elijah to heaven. With a life. He did not die. He was taken away with a life. The same way, the people who are here must be taken away. There will be a message. There will be a messenger. The messenger will be coming. He will take away your life with a life. Now, Elijah's message was a testimony for the people of Israel. The same message was given to John the Baptist. The same message was preached by John the Baptist. John chapter 1, verse 22. It says that, please ask John, who are you? Are you Elijah? Are you Jesus Christ? He said, no. I'm not Elijah. I'm not Jesus Christ. I am the voice, one who crying in the wilderness. I am the voice of one who cried in the wilderness. They asked, who are you? I'm John the Baptist. Matthew chapter 3, verse 1, it says that, behold, I sent my messenger to prepare the way before I come. This is supposed to be that the message is supposed to be finished. The message, the Messiah comes before the Messiah comes. So Jesus says, before I come, I'm going to send a messenger. That is John the Baptist. So now he is working for the redemption of the people who are in the wilderness. What was the message that was given to Jonah? This was the message that was given. Jonah cried the wickedness by 40 days. Nineveh is going to destroy. Jonah, please, 40 days, then Nineveh will be destroyed. Moses cried out, Pharaoh will be destroyed, and he will allow the people to come out of Egypt. Elijah cried out to turn the heart of the father to son, and son to father. And there's a repentance, repentance, it has already been there. John the Baptist copies all this message, and he said, John the Baptist said, I am the voice of the one who cried in the wilderness. Now, if we study the whole other people, they were all in the wilderness, searching for their restoration from the land of wilderness. Mm-hmm. Now, finally, God appointed John the Baptist to come and redeem the people from the wilderness. So John said, I'm here. My voice is the one who cried for the people who live in the wilderness. Dr. Buford, he says, true worship is not just something that happens during religious rituals, but it is about living a life that shares God's message. True life is not something happening during the religious life. We all are Christians. We think that once we accepted Jesus, once we named as Christ a Christian, we are saved. No. And Dr. Thamson, he clearly says that it is about the living life that you share God's message. Unless and until you and I share the message to the people who are in wickedness, we are not considered as Christians. John the Baptist was giving that message. Elijah was giving that message. Jonah was giving that message. Moses was giving that message. Matthew 12:40. For Jonah was 3 days and 3 nights in the belly of great fish. It talks about very big message, talks about the day of three. Go to the life of Jesus Christ. How many years he was here for ministry? 3.5 years. What about Elijah? He was asking Ahab, 3.5 years, no rain. How many days he was? Jesus was in the tomb. 3 days. So if you go through, three has a very real implication in the words of scripture. It has a very great implication. That implication shows that there is something is going to happen. God said, I will destroy this church and rebuild within 3 days. It's turning on our own life. We are the temple of God. If God is not living in us, our life will be destroyed. But if God turns on us, it can be rebuilt within time. The message that must come to us. Therefore, Jesus says, I'm the life, I'm the way, and I'm the truth. Beside me, no one can enter into the kingdom of God. Psalms 23:1. He's a shepherd. And we are the sheep behind him. If he guides, we can just go even the good pastures and get to the right place where we are. But here, it says that. John 3:3, it says that. Jesus clearly says. The Messiah clearly says, truly, truly, I say unto you, unless one is born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. Being a Christian, you cannot enter the kingdom of God unless you turn your life into a different, unless you turn the life and born again, you cannot enter the kingdom of God. Mrs. Rice, she says like this, this life is a school which to prepare for examination of heaven with regard to purity, cleanliness of thought, and unselfishness of action. If our life cannot be changed, these qualities, purity, cleanliness, and unselfishness, our life is a waste. We are not having the real message in our life. One day, a rich man, a rich dad, took his son to a trip in a village. He wanted to show his son how the poor people live there and how they are just dying their life in the society. He took the son in a farm where the people were living and working together and living. On the return, the rich dad asked the son, how was the trip? Son replied, it was great, Dad. It was great. The dad asked the son, what did you learn after this trip? The son said, we have one God, but they have four. We have one pool, but they have a big river. We buy food, they grow for them. We have electricity for light, they have stars. We have words to protect us, but they have friends to protect them. We have television, but they have families to entertain. The father was done. He could not give a word to the son. The son smiled
a father and said, thanks, Dad, for showing me and to understand how poor we are. How poor we are. We are not rich, we are very poor. He said, our relationship with God is selfish. Whereas they are with their friends and enjoy their life with God's nature. And the son was giving a very positive message to the father. We think that we are great in this life. We have no harm. We live very happy. But the son was giving a message to the father that we are undergoing a great danger. We don't know who we are. They live with the nature of God that was given to them. But we live for ourselves. This is the message was given to Jonah. Jonah was given to the message what God wants him to do, but he took his own position in his life. Our trial is now over. We don't know how we are preparing ourselves to meet the Lord. The message is already given to us. Messiah is coming. Second time, Jonah. Jonah accepted second time. Jesus Christ is coming in his second time. Whether he will be accepted or not. When he comes the second time, if we are not accepted, we are just like Jonah who ran away from the presence of God. Jonah did not have the relationship with God first. But God kept the relationship with him. Now today, God is asking whether we keep our relationship with God or not. If our conditions, our pure condition is turning into wickedness, our life is in danger. God wants us to be in the pure guideline. God read the heart of Jonah. So he kept a big fish to save his life. The same way, God is leading one of us. He is leading everyone who sits here. God wants us to be safe side. He says even if we walk under the sea, he is going to protect us. But are we of the same nature to accept it? If we are not under the guidance of God, our relationship with God will be in danger. God gave us opportunity to accept as Messiah. But we reject his option as a creator. If we do not accept our Lord as our creator and Messiah, our life in this world is nothing. It's nothing. Therefore, brothers and sisters, Ellen White, again she says, the identity of a Christian is not an outward sign, nor wearing a cross around our neck, or holding a Bible walking around the street, but must reveal the union of man with God. If you do not reveal our unionship with the Lord, carrying a Bible, and just, you know, putting a, outwardly putting a sign around the neck, there is nothing. Being a Christian, that has no value at all. Therefore, today, Mrs. Weiss, she gives
a very good advice to you. Being a Christian is not an outward sign, nor wearing a cross around our neck. Hold the Bible. That must reach to the people, to keep the people towards the union of God. In conclusion, brothers and sisters, are we going to run away as Jonah did first, or accept
as Jonah the second time asked you to go and preach? If you accept, there is something you might understand. Our life thinks that we are living in profit. But what does it say? Mark 8:36. What does it profit a man to gain the whole world and forfeit his soul?
If you think that our life here, being in America, earning money, living like very rich, fellowship, you are not going to gain nothing. You don't gain nothing. And still, you are getting away from the process of the Lord. Jeremiah 17:17, it says that blessed is the one who trusts in the Lord, whose confidence in Him. If you and I have the confidence in the Lord who gave the life, you are blessed. If not, we are cursed. Therefore, Isaiah warns us. He warns us. Arise! The light has come. This is the time. Think of it. Arise and show the real life that's supposed to come out of your life. My life, your life must be a shining one. May the Spirit of God touch your heart, through which we will be able to understand the real life that was set before us. Therefore, shine your life. Keep away from wickedness and pray and dedicate yourself for the service of God. Messiah is going to come.
Amen.
Thank you, Pastor Bovas, for the kind of message. May God bless you and your lovely family as a minister in him. For a closing song, let's all rise up and sing the song. Rescue the perishing, care for the dying. Every individual's responsibility is to rescue people who are in need. You and I have a responsibility. That's the message. And that's the song that we want to sing. Let's do the perishing, care for the dying, snatch their pity from sin and the dead. But we have also song.
Yeah.
merciful, kind and loving Father. What a blessed time that you have given us to dedicate our life before thee. As Jonah, this time his life was turned away from God, Lord. When you gave him a lesson, he understood the life and came back near to your world. Help us to be with you and near them, near to you, to share the life which he has given to us. Lord, today we submit our hearts before thee. Keep us away from the harm and dangers that is before us. Keep us away from the wickedness that we live in. Lord, today, once again, we submit our hearts before thee. Help us to be loyal and fruitful to the end. We ask these blessings in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. May the presence of God and the love of Lord Jesus Christ and the Holy Communion of our Holy Ghost be with you forever and ever.
Thank you all for joining and being a part of HopeSide Community Church, and I hope that you all been blessed today. And may God bless you as you care for the needs of the community as you go out with the heart of worship. And anyone who needs prayer papers, want us to visit your homes, whatever the little thing that we can do through our church, we're very happy to. Please contact me, or you can be able to message online too, and we'll be very happy that we will be able to be a part of you anytime. And thank you once again for being with us. And we do have fellowship lunch in the next building. We want you to please join in and spend and fellowship with us. And then hopefully, God willing, we will be able to meet you again for a special program next week. Till then, may God bless you. Maranatha, Jesus is coming again.
Thank you.